And welcome to our online worship here on YouTube for St Martin's in the Bullring, Birmingham. Thank you very much for joining us, and we very much hope you'll enjoy being part of our worship today on this Trinity Sunday, when we celebrate our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. May I take this opportunity as we begin to reiterate my deep thanks and the thanks of the whole church community for all those who contribute week by week to these online services, those who work so hard to put the whole thing together. We are really very, very grateful for all you do. In a little while in the worship, I'm going to lead us in communion on behalf of the whole church community. But if you'd like to join in your own way at home, you might want to pause this recording and go and get some bread and wine or some fruit juice, wafer, whatever would help you. And then you can join in with communion at home. Equally, you might like to get hold of a Bible so that you can follow our reading as later on Flo reads for us from Philippians chapter 2. Let's be quiet for a moment and then I'm going to lead us in prayer. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, we love you. God around us, God with us, God inside us, we worship you. God above, God beside, God below, we praise you. God of the past, God of the present, God of the future, we honour you. God of here, God of there, God of everywhere, we thank you. Loving God, for all you are, all you do, all you mean, we give you thanks and praise and offer you our love and worship. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Spirit.
St. Paul says, be imitators of God. Love as Jesus loved. Do not grieve the Holy Spirit. Put away all anger and bitterness, all slander and malice. So let us confess our sins to God, who forgives us in Christ and fills us with his Spirit. Father, you come to meet us when we return to you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Jesus, you died on the cross for our sins. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Spirit, you give us life and peace. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May our loving Father forgive us, wash away all our sins, and help us to start again through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Dear friends, you always followed my instructions when I was with you, and now that I am away, it is even more important work hard to show the results of your salvation, obeying God with deep reverence and fear. For God is working in you, giving you the desire and the power to do what pleases him. Do everything without complaining and arguing, so that no one can criticize you. Live clean, innocent, live as children of God, shining like bright lights in a world full of crooked and perverse people. Hold firmly to the word of life, then on the day of Christ's return, I will be proud that I did not run the race in vain and that my work was not useless. But I will rejoice even if I lose my life, pouring it out like a liquid offering to God, just like your faithful servant is an offering to God. And I want all of you to share that joy. Yes, you should rejoice, and I will share your joy. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Let us pray. Father, may we hear your voice, only your voice. Amen. I would like to ask you a question, and perhaps you wanted to grab a piece of paper and a pen to write the answer down, or maybe just make a mental note of it. When you get interrupted, what is your reaction? When your life, the way you want to live, is interrupted, do you feel angry, frustrated, impatient? Do you complain or do you pray? I would like to say I pray, but I don't always. I often get frustrated and complain. No doubt, most of us over the past several weeks have had our lives interrupted. The way we do church has changed. We miss gathering with a cup of coffee and chatting. Jobs, relationships, plans and dreams have put on hold. And it is difficult to maintain a sense that all is well. It is difficult to do what the Apostle Paul says in his letter to the Philippians. Do everything without complaining or arguing. Complaining or expressing our frustrations is, of course, quite natural. But it becomes a problem when we miss the opportunity to transform our complaining and our frustrations into opportunities. And the problem comes when we allow anger and pain to take over in a such way that we become blind and we cannot see beyond those interruptions. Let me pick up two things that Paul talks about in this passage. At the end of verse 12, Paul says, continue to work out your salvation with fear and trembling. Now, this continual working out is not to gain our salvation, because as Christians, we already have that. This working out of our salvation is to do with the choices we have to make in our lives, especially when we face interruptions. For example, if I have a choice of A, B, C, what should I take? What the outcome would be? But there is good news in here, because we do not do that on our own. Have a look at verse 13. It says, this working out is in the knowledge that it is God who works in you to will and act accordingly to his purpose. And I think this is good news. We are not on our own. We have God's word, the Bible. I like to read the Psalms when interruptions come to disturb me, when frustrations come. You know, I want to go back to God, to what God has promised or said in the past. I like to read again the passages that once brought some comfort to me. What does it say? What did you say yesterday? And what does it say today? The second thing I wanted to pick up on is what Paul says after he instructed the Philippians to do everything without complaining or arguing. He goes on to say, do not complain so that you may be blameless and pure, children without fault in a crooked and depraved generation, in which you shine like stars in the universe. To shine like the stars is not to complain. No arguing. It is to be blameless, to be pure, and to hold out the word of life. We shine with our lives and our lips because God works in us through our obedience, through our imitating of Christ, and above all, through the power of the Holy Spirit, who is constantly prompting us to act according to his will and purposes. We shine like the stars to light our own darkness, but also to light the darkness of others. To shine like the stars, we constantly pray, Lord Jesus, deliver me from myself. Lord Jesus, lighten my darkness. Jesus, let me have self-knowledge, self-control. Give me true love to all people, and may your will be done in my life. I don't know what you wrote on the paper or what mental note you made to the question, when you are interrupted, what is your reaction? Unfortunately, we don't need COVID-19 to have those interruptions. We have them anyway, don't we? So, why don't you grab another piece of paper and pen and write this down, or make a mental note of this, please? When our life is interrupted, let's remember that Jesus worked out our salvation by turning the cross into victory. And we work out our own salvation by turning our interruptions into victory. If the interruptions place you in darkness, remember, that it is being in darkness that will give you a chance to shine like the stars.
The Father, the Almighty.
Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God.
Eternally begotten of the Father.
God from God, light from light.
True God from true God.
Begotten, not made. Of one being with the Father.
Through him all things were made.
For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven,
was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man.
For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered death and was buried.
On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceed from the Father and from the Son.
Who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church.
We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins.
We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The bidding for our prayers is, Lord, in your mercy, and the response, hear our prayer. On this Trinity Sunday, we have come before you, Lord, to offer our praise and adoration. You are God, the Creator, giving us richly all things to enjoy. You are Christ, the Saviour of the world, made flesh to set us free. And you are the Spirit of truth and love, willing to dwell in us. You are holy, you are one God, eternal Trinity. Heavenly Father, we pray for your world. We pray for peace and justice. We also pray for those in nations where COVID-19 cases are increasing. We ask that you help those in authority to balance the many voices they hear in order that they make wise decisions that will lead to a dampening of the pandemic worldwide, as well as greater understanding of how we can all work together for justice and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, we pray for your church throughout the world, that it may know the breadth of your love and your goodness in these extraordinary times. We pray for our leaders, for Bishop Anne and David, and for Jeremy, Elsie and Abba, that they may continue to know your love and blessings. Thank you that we can meet digitally to share your good news with others, even though we cannot meet physically. Thank you for the community of St. Martin's, and especially for Philippa as she coordinates our online worship. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Holy Spirit, we give you thanks for the communities in which we live. We thank you for doctors, nurses, and medical researchers, that through their skill and insights, many will be restored to health. We especially thank you for teams at City Hospital. Please strengthen them in their work. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear God, we pray for all who have recently lost a loved one. Be with them in their loneliness so they may know that Christ overcame death for us. We remember the family and friends of Ismay Chisholm, whose funeral was last week. We also remember those who are sick, sad, or lonely. We pray particularly for those who have asked for our petitions, Ellie Louise, Jennifer, Inanna, Kathleen, and Rosemary. We pray that they may be aware of your comforting presence and know that in your hands they are safe and loved. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Finally, we pray in silence for ourselves and our ministries as we try to shine like stars in a dark world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Now to God, who is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or conceive, by the power which is at work among us, be glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus throughout all ages. Amen.
Peace to you from God, our Heavenly Father. peace from his Son, Jesus Christ, who is our peace. Peace from the Holy Spirit, the life giver. The peace of the Lord be always with you. The Lord is here, his Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord. All that you reveal of your glory, the same we believe of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, without any difference or inequality. We, your holy church, acclaim you, Father of majesty unbounded, your true and only Son, worthy of all worship, and the Holy Spirit, advocate and guide. Three persons, we adore you, one in being and equal in majesty. And so with angels and archangels, we sing forever of your glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. To the darkness, Jesus came as your light. With signs of faith and words of hope, he touched untouchables with love and washed the guilty clean. The crowds came out to meet your Son, yet at the end, they turned on him. On the night he was betrayed, he came to table with his friends to celebrate the freedom of your people. Jesus blessed you, Father, for the food. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said, "This is my body given for you all." Jesus then gave thanks for the wine. He took the cup, gave it and said, "This is my blood, shed for you all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate the cross on which Jesus died to set us free. Defying death, he rose again and is alive with you to plead for us and for the world. Send your Holy Spirit on us now, that by these gifts we may feed on Christ with opened eyes and hearts on fire. May we and all who share this food offer ourselves to live for you and be welcomed at your feast in heaven, when all creation worships you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. the body of Christ. The blood of Christ. Almighty and eternal God, you have revealed yourself as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and live and reign in the perfect unity of love. Hold us firm in this faith, that we may know you in all your ways, and evermore rejoice in your eternal glory, who are three persons, yet one God, now and forever. Amen. So for Trinity Sunday, I thought it would be good for us to conclude our worship by joining in praying the grace for one another. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.